Hello students, in this video we'll be solving some problems based on the criterias or the rules that we learned, congruence rules that we learned about triangles from exercise 7.1 of the NCERT book. First question is, in quadrilateral ABCD, the one which you can see in the figure, AC is given equal to AD. AB bisects angle A over here, and we are asked to show that or prove that triangle ABC, this triangle, is congruent to triangle ABD, this triangle. These two triangles have to be shown congruent. Let us begin by solving what we have been given. So let us begin with the two triangles in question, that is in triangle ABC and in triangle ABD. To prove congruent, we need to prove various sides or angles equal to each other, the corresponding sides or corresponding angle. Let us see in this case what we can prove equal to each other and ultimately prove that the two triangles are congruent to each other. So in triangle ABC and triangle ABD, what have we been given first? We have been given that AC is equal to AD. Now AC belongs to triangle ABC and AD belongs to triangle ABD. So we can say, if we have a look carefully, they are corresponding, AC and AD, and these are given as equal to each other. So we write over here the reason that it is given, AC is equal. So we've got one side, corresponding side equal. What else we have been given? We have been given that AB bisects angle A. AB, this line, bisects angle A over here. What it means by bisecting means it divides the angle into two equal parts, which means we can easily say that angle CAB is equal to angle DAB. And notice how I have taken the angles. C, I'll show you over here. I'll mark them with numbers over here. So C, A, B. Similarly over here, I've taken D, A, B. Okay, in that particular order I've taken. And over here in the figure, it looks like this. C, A, B and D, A, B. Okay, and the reason we write over here is AB bisects angle A. Now we have got side, we have got an angle. Now we can see if we get another side, and we do get a side. Have notice AB, the side AB is common to both the triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ABD as well. So we can say AB is equal to AB. One AB coming from here and one AB coming from here. So we can say common side. That will be our reason over here. So we write common side. Now we've got side, we've got an angle, we've got a side. Okay, and they are corresponding. Side, angle and side. As a result, I'll mark this like this. So we can say that the two triangles, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. And the reason we can give is SAS, side angle side congruence criterion. Why? So that is what we were asked to show. We were asked to show that the two triangles are congruent. We have done that by showing that we've got two corresponding sides and an angle between them equal to each other. Fine. Let's move to the next problem. The next problem says ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AD is equal to BC and angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. We are asked to prove triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. And we are also asked to prove BD, which is BD, equal to AC and angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. So the two triangles in question are actually the triangles we are asked to prove. That is triangle ABD and triangle BAC. So what I'll do in this, this figure confuses us. So I'll just draw the triangles in question and leave out the unnecessary part. That is, I'll show you. So we need triangle ABD, right? So what I'll do is, same thing I'm drawing. Okay. Okay. But I'm leaving out this DC side. So D and the C, I'm not joining DC. This is just to make it easier for you to understand. Now, we are asked to prove that triangle ABD and triangle BAC. So BAC and ABD, these two triangles are congruent to each other. So let us see. So we'll start with those two triangles. So in triangle ABD and triangle BAC, what can we prove? What have we have been given? AD is equal to BC. So AD is equal to BC we have been given. So if you have a look, these are corresponding AD, BC. So AD equal to BC, and that is, sorry, that is given. Next, we have also been given DAB is equal to CBA. Angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. And we'll mark this as given. So have a look. DAB and CBA. Right? And we've got side, we've got angle. Can we get another side? And we do. Have a look at AB. AB is common to both the triangles. Triangle ABD and triangle BAC as well. This side is common to both. So, AB is common to both. Have a look. AB, BA. So, AB you can say is equal to BA. And that is common side. So, side, angle, side. We can prove that these two triangles are congruent. So, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. Once again, it is SAS congruence criterion. Our next part was we are asked to prove BD is equal to AC. Where does BD fall? BD is part of this triangle. That is triangle ABD. And AC is a part of triangle BAC. We can say that BD is equal to AC. And how? We can say because of CPCT. And CPCT stands for, I'll just write it over here once again, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Remember, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are always equal to each other. So BD is equal to AC, hence proved. Similarly, we can also say angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. Once again, same thing, CPCT. Okay, I'll just write here. CPCT. How? Have a look. ABD belongs to triangle ABD, and we have BAC belonging to triangle BAC. So they are corresponding angles, and because the two triangles have been proved already congruent, we can say they are the congruent parts. Hence, we can say that the congruent parts corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Okay. So in this video, we solve this two questions under exercise 7.8. If you have liked the video, please click the like button, share it with your friends and classmates. Please subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications when a new video is posted. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.